Would you like to understand the type of technical skills necessary to become an incredible cloud architect? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Mike Gibbs, and I'm the CEO of GoCloud Careers. You can find my clients working at AWS, Microsoft Azure, Cisco, IBM, Google, Zscaler, Palo Alto Networks, Accenture, Deloitte, KPMG, and many other elite organizations. And I want to help you build an elite cloud architect career. Whether that's helping you get your first cloud architect job or getting promoted to be a principal architect, I want to help you. And I have some free gifts for you at the end of this video to help you in your cloud architect career. One of the biggest challenges that keeps people from becoming cloud architects is getting the wrong technical skills. As cloud architects, we must have deep technical skills, but we don't really touch the technology in our jobs. For example, as cloud architects, we don't code, we don't administer technology, and we don't troubleshoot technology either. We design technology, and that requires a very different skill set than the technicals necessary for hands-on engineering roles. And even if you perform hundreds of hands-on cloud projects, you still won't have the technicals necessary to become a cloud architect, as that will teach you how to build and not how to design. That's why the people that build a hotel, engineers and construction workers, are not asked to design a hotel. Architects design the hotel, but they don't build it. It's the same reason airplane pilots are not asked to design an airplane. So why doesn't hands-on experience teach you how to design? The level of knowledge needed to design is much deeper than the level of knowledge learned by doing cloud projects or working as a cloud engineer, DevOps engineer, or any hands-on role. Cloud architecture or system design is about how things work, both independently and as a system, as opposed to how to build. For example, I bet you know how to use a web browser, but do you really know what happens after you enter a URL like www.gocloudcareers.com into your web browser? Now, even if you build the web server and write the code for the website, you still really won't know what happens once you enter the URL in your browser. Sure, the web developer will know the code, but what about the network, the routers, the switches, and firewalls along the way? I'll give you a 30-second example of what happens when you go to a website so you can see it from the architect's perspective. For example, once you type www.gocloudcareers.com into your browser, the first thing that happens is your PC does a DNS lookup and finds the IP address of our site, which happens to be 162.159.136.54. Next, your PC is going to look in its routing table to see if it knows how to reach the IP address of the website. Assuming it has a route, it will follow that, but if it doesn't, your PC will look to its default gateway. And assuming your PC is plugged into an Ethernet switch, your PC will then look to find the MAC address of the website. So your PC will send an ARP request to see who has the MAC address of the website. Next, your default gateway will answer your ARP request with a proxy ARP and reply to your message. Then your default gateway will look in its routing table and forward its packet to the next router, and this process will happen again and again until the packet reaches the destination web server. Then your PC will set up a TCP connection, and then TCP will control the flow of the data to your PC. That's what actually happened under the hood. Now, that's not the entire system, but I just wanted to give you an example so you could see things from an architect's perspective. As you can see, you may have used a web browser your entire life, but it didn't teach you anything about how the system works. Neither will creating a Python script, Terraform script, or even setting up an EC2 instance at AWS. See, that's engineering, where you're setting up what's in front of you. Architecture is about the entire system. Now, to be a cloud architect and design a system, you must know how each individual part works and how they work together as a whole. So, what do you really need to know to become a great cloud architect? Deep understanding of networking, data center, security, and cloud technology, how each component works independently, and how you put them together into a cloud architecture. Architecture is like the perfect recipe. It takes the perfect ingredients and the right combinations to truly be successful. Now, the list of things that you know to become a great cloud architect is a rather extensive list. So I've included a free ebook on how to get your first cloud architect job, which will list everything you need to know to become a competent cloud architect. The book will cover all of the required cloud architect skills, whether they be technical skills, and it will list all of them, or business skills. And feel free to join me on how to become the ultimate cloud architect webinar. It's completely free, and you can ask me questions live so I can help you build the ultimate cloud computing career. Please remember to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and hit the notification bell to be informed of free videos that can help you in your cloud architect career. I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.